everybody. So the instructions are to basically create a 1,000 by 1,072 document. Let me show you how that's done. So you can click on New File, and then here, okay, on this left-hand side right here, you'll see the width and the inches. Don't worry about it. You can keep this untitled. You know, if you want to name it, you can, but you'll find out it doesn't really matter. So I'm going to go ahead and change this to pixels. So when I say 1,000, okay, it's always pixels. You don't want to create anything 1,000 inches. I got a problem with that pretty much every year. So I'm going to choose 1,000 by 1,000 by 72. Okay, so there we have it. Everything else should be okay, but background, I would prefer it to be white. All right, let's go out a little bit. So now you have it here. So 1,000 by 1,000, 72. The background should be white. Don't worry about the advanced icon. That's all just stuff. So I'm going to go ahead and create it. All right. Now, I'm going to zoom out a little bit, move this over. Because, and I'm going to move, I'm going to drag the toolbar this side there. So what I'm going to talk about the points word cloud is, I'm going to ask you to click on the text or the type tool. Okay, text tool, type tool, same thing. So if you click here, okay, and I click on horizontal type tool. And one thing you have to remember here, okay, so I'm just going to go and click here. And you'll notice that it'll say it's kind of one of all the colors. Let me go ahead and change it to a different color. So maybe I should move this up a little bit. So here's how you change colors, and this is also how you change colors. And you see it'll say lorem ipsum, okay? And you'll see right here that this part on the very top, okay, whenever I click on type, in fact, every time I click on a different tool in the toolbar, it changes. Top part. This is called the option bar right here. Alrighty, and go over again and shrink function a little bit so you can see everything. Okay, so I am going to go ahead and tell you that if I click on, see this is the option bar here, this is the toolbar. So if I click on the type tool, you have all these options. So since I've already have a word, lorem ipsum, that's just a nice way of saying, space. Or maybe a space one. Okay, so if I was to change the, I can change it to whatever I want. This, if I click on this, you notice that the font will change. Let me go ahead and increase the size of the font. There's several ways I can do this. Here, notice that it has this measured in points. So I can go down to 72, and look at that, the number increases, okay? Now we can better show you if I move show you, you'll notice that the text changes as I scroll through different fonts here. This right here is a type, okay, so this is the type of font, in other words, a style of font, rather, style. So this is the font, this is the style of that font. Now some fonts, like say Arial, we're all familiar, has four styles, okay, about that. Others have two, others have one. So here is a type tool. Now, if I move the cursor over the text and type tool right here, you'll notice that I can move it left or right. You see the two arrows there pointing left or right? I can go left, I can go right. There we go. All right, and finally, I'm going to show you how to change the color of the fonts. Okay, so there you have it. This is the color picker. All right, so what is this involved? Well, notice that it says number 62 point. This is the points word cloud. So all you can do is just type in 62 points. Okay, there you go. And I'm going to click on the marquee tool here to get out of the text mode. And then you'll notice right here on the layers palette, by the way, you can go to Windows and you click on layers. You should see layers somewhere. All right, I'm going to show you later on how to create a workspace. Right now, if you can just find the layers palette, okay, that would be ideal. That would be okay. Alright, so what you're going to do now is you're going to go to every number you create is going to have its own layer. So we're going to go to layer, new layer, layer, new layer. And you'll notice here it'll ask you what it is. You can just leave it alone. That's okay, and a new layer shows up here. See that? So now I'm going to go ahead and press the type tool and I'm going to click on that layer. See, number 62 has already been utilized. Now there's a new layer. One. So now I'm going to go ahead and type in, say, well, what do I want to do? I'm going to put in a different different font. Okay, that's good. I'm going to choose a different style. See, there's this example of one style font. But I'm going to increase this, and I'm going to change the color. So this is very purple, pink. This one is size 81. So choose 81 points. That's what I want to do. There we go. Okay, let's start again. Layer, new layer. Okay, I'll just press OK. There's a new layer. I'm going to go ahead and make sure the type tool is collected. I'm going to go ahead and type, and I'm going to change the font. Something that I can read. That's nice to have that. And I'm going to choose, again, another one with just a simple, single style. And I'm going to go ahead and increase this to 169. And change the font color. Press OK. There I have it. And this one I'm going to change to 169. So you see what I'm trying to see where I'm getting at? Let's do one more cycle here. Layer, new layer. Layer, new layer. Okay, press OK. Then I'm going to press T. Okay, and I'm going to go ahead and find the new font. Let's go with this one, okay, and this one again is also 169, but I'm going to change the color, and then I'm going to go ahead and make it bigger. Have it. I'm not going to see, but it doesn't matter because I'm going to change it to 43. Yes, okay, and that's what I'd like for you to do. So come up with about say 10 of these, and then what you'll do now is you will save it as a JPEG, so file. Okay, well actually I'm going to show you how to flatten this. Okay, so you don't want to have it like this. So there's a little hamburger icon right here. Click, and you'll see it'll say flatten. Hard to see there, but if you take my word on it, it'll say flatten. It's the last time I ever did it like this. So I'm sorry to say this, but right under merge visible, you'll see flatten. Okay, and I hate to say this, but I can, well, let me see if I can do this. Up a little bit, this down a little bit, and let me see if I bring this out. That okay, there it is, flatten image right there. See, if I click on flatten image, notice that now it has a single image called background. So I'm going to put this back, and we'll talk about how to do that later. Then I'm going to ask you to save it as a JPEG. So file, save as. Okay, so whatever, and call it Word Cloud. So first thing you want to do is change format to JPEG.